guys, George here, and welcome back to another episode of Garage Edition. I think this is our second episode working on Colossus, our YouTube build truck. Today, it's a beautiful day, so I was like, let's go ahead and put some LEDs. Now, we're going to take the gauge cluster off, and we'll put LEDs in. Simple twist switch bulb. We're actually switching it to blue, but it kind of has a purplish color because I said we're going to do kind of a purple neon color lights with this truck. So we are going to install, it's a bluish purple, real pretty. Now I have done this install before on the Super Ram, my other Dodge, but I said we wasn't going to turn a bolt on this unless it's on film. So I'm going to show you how to do it again, but in further detail. So further ado, let's get started. All right, so we got our lights. Let's see, it does come with paper, and I've installed this before, so I know how they go. But it also says if these lights, they just twist in, does not work on the first thing, you need to take it back out and twist them a little bit, because these twist in, so they might not make good contact. So that's a reminder to do. Now these didn't cost me, but I think it says on there only maybe $6 or $7 off of eBay. It might be more now because I have had them for a while. So we're actually going to put these in. I think I have the old ones on the other one. Yeah. If you don't know what your old bulbs look like, I will show you. These are out of my 99 Dodge, aka the Super Ram. Look it up on Instagram and you'll see it. Here is the bulbs that come out. This is a smaller bulb. These are the much larger bulbs. So this is what we're actually going to replace. See, these have a little twist in area, so that these just put the bulb in the carrier and they'll actually just go straight in. And here's where it makes contact. This is the reason why they say make sure you can turn it and stuff. Right there and right there. That's what powers the bulb. So make sure those are making metal contact on your dash cluster. Now I installed this before, had no problem. One of the problems I have had, it might just been a bad batch. Some of the lights now, they're blinking because where they're going off, but I've had it in there for, it's been since summer, and that was last year. So these do pretty good. Might just been a bad batch. The lights are still going, but they blink every now and then. So I will be replacing them in the Super Ram, but I figured, hey, let's put these in there because this was for Super Ram, but let's put these in Colossus. Now, I never say anything about safety, but when you're working on your vehicle, even because we do got to do something to the gear shifter in there, put you a Scotch. That's just a board that I put behind there. And it doesn't have any nails, so if I do back over it, which I have, it won't hurt anything. But that's just for protection, so it won't back down the driveway or anything. So take time to protect yourself. All right, so we want to get our tools. We got our tools, our wrenches. Well, sockets, whatever you want to call it. You need a Phillips head screwdriver. Now, first thing you want to do, we will have to move all this. Turn your damn light out so your battery don't go dead. We need to take this bottom plate off. But wait, George, we're supposed to be changing the dash up there, not down here. Well, I'll show you why you got to do that for. So go ahead. There's one bolt here. One bolt here, which it's missing because this wasn't my truck to start out with, so somebody's had it off. And one bolt here. So you can use a Phillips head or socket, wrench, whatever you want, but I'm going to use a Phillips head. All right, keep this in mind. If anything back here doesn't look right, I have not touched this truck. I've done nothing to this, so if something ain't done right, it's not me, and we will fix it right. So we got that one off. Take the other two, just my camera. Ugh. All right, so that is off. So we did that. So if you take those three out, which I only had two, you want to remove this bottom panel.
And it clips in also, so. You got clips that you have to do, as you see. One, two. Now, this one looks like it doesn't have the this on. Put that back on because that actually stops the rattling and stuff. So, you want to try to put everything back on. Boy, it needs cleaned. Put back everything back on that you take off. So, put this back here. Alright, so, see, if anybody did any splice of wiring, and it looks like they did, that was not me, so I just want to make that clear. So right now, what we want to do is, up here, right there, trying to get the camera to focus good so you can see what I'm trying to do here. Right, there we go, here, this little clip, so right here has to come off. This little wire, there we go, that little right wire right there has to come off, because when you pull that off, pull this out, that way when you take your cluster out, that wire goes with it, because that shows that you're in park, drive, and neutral. So do not go ripping that out up there, because if you break that, then it will not show what gear you're in. So we're going to pull that off, just real simple. Try to fix my tripod again. You do have a little slack, so you can pull it. Then, basically, you take this, and it slides out. And all it does, just it slides in there, hooks, and it slides right out. So, that is free. So, when we do pull that up, we'll pull it up through there with our dash panel. So, let's go ahead and take the bezel off. Alright, so we got to take this piece off right here. Now, my piece is actually cracked right here. So we're going to have to be pretty careful with it. Now the Super Ram actually has a double den that I built, so it's easy to pull off and stuff. This, not so much. So we're going to take your time. There we go. Pop it away. Don't break it, because these bezels right here are about $100 just for, you can almost just a used one. It's ridiculous that the price is still high on these trucks, but I guess everybody breaks them. So, we want to do this right here. Oh, now usually we'll have to put it in neutral, which I said, you put that thing on your wheel, you won't have to worry about it.
Only at Buffalo Trail.
Alright, turn the radio off. There we go. There we go. And see, this one's already broke, so I told you it had a broken piece on it right there. Not really worried about that, because we're going to do something crazy with the dash this summer anyways. Screw that. Screw that stock look. If you like stock look, there's nothing wrong with that. All right, put it back up. Put your wheel back up. Turn your keys off, whatever you want to do. Now, here you have one screw here, one screw. It's not the little silver screws, it's the black screws. One up there, one there. So you got four screws total. So let's go ahead and take them out. They're all Phillips head. Do the camera good. Four screws. We want to keep those. Remember, don't lose your screws. and don't lose the screws out of the bottom down here. So what you want to do is you want to go ahead and set your camera so you can see what you're doing. And you want to go ahead and take this out. Now behind here there's a big strip of a plug-in, and you don't have to take no wires off. Basically you just pull it out, and then when you put it in you just push it back in. You'll see what I'm talking about just here in a second. We're going to have to put the gear shift down again. Now remember, this is a tricky part. Other people is like, oh, you got to take all this apart to get this stuff off. I'm not taking all this junk off. I got the other one out. We'll get this one out. You just got to take your time and don't get angry. And have patience. I do all of those. So what I'll do is put this back down. Put it down drive. Take your time. All right, remember that little wire back here that you got to pull? Don't forget that. You don't want to break that or anything. So, there's that. It's what we need. The lights go back here. So let's go ahead and take this in the shop and do what we need to do. Remember why I said you want to take no wires off? You don't. This right here, basically, it's just a plug and play plug in on the back of there. When you put it in, just make sure it's seated properly and make sure you're not bent. You didn't bend any of the pins or anything, because you want everything to work. There's no cables or anything, which I like, because it's all actually electrical. You think on a model of this truck, everything, you'd have 500 cables in, but you don't. So really happy with that. So that's easy to do. Just pull it out. Remember, just take your time. Like I was reading and watching one guy. He's like, oh, you got to take all this out. No, you don't. Just take your time. Take minimum what you have to take out. I wish you didn't have to take this down here out, but you do. But I mean, that doesn't take long. We've done this all in less than 5 minutes. So let's go ahead and take it in the shop and work on the gauges. So this is what the back looks like after we got it out and everything. Comes with this little cardboard here. Now, my fat little pudgy fingers won't fit down in there to actually turn it. So what I do is I take this off, but I put it back on. Just got to be real careful, because you are dealing with electronics and stuff. You don't want to mess anything up. So I'm actually going to take this off. You don't have to if you think you can fit your fingers down in there. I can't fit mine down there and feel comfortable about it. So I'm going to go ahead and take this cover off of it. This off, don't lose it. Don't lose any of your screws either. Alright, so the big ones is what we want to change first. We should have enough of these. Now for the small ones, we don't have enough for small ones. But you can actually read on here which ones you want. Now these are the signal lights. I know that middle is high beam. Let's see, this is their speedometer. You got your fuel. I think this is just the middle light. I think that might light up the middle. Now this one's empty. It's for upshift. Now I think that might be for like the diesel or something. Low fuel, ABS, cruise, check engine, overdrive, washer fluid. Now if you have a diesel, I think it'll be different, because you have your glow plug light and everything. So what we're going to do is we're actually going to switch these out. So let's go ahead and open a pack up. Just be gentle with it. Be gentle. Be gentle. All right, let's move this back some. All right. So here is our LED lights. It's gonna be a pretty blue. So what you want to do is
you take this and you put it down in here, the holder. Make sure you don't break it or anything. Just take a little push to get it down in there. There's our holder. We want to do our turn signal. Basically, all you do is turn it, take it out. There's that one. Now, I keep my old ones just in case. This, basically, let me try to get a zoom up of it. Basically, it goes in like this. Make sure you have the two tabs. It's in, and then you turn it. Just like that. Just make sure those are touching, because you want to make metal contact with it. Ugh. There we go. That was good, so we're going to do the other one. Basically, it just turns. We'll take one of these. Slide it in there. If it don't go, we'll put it in the other way. There we go. Slide that in real gently. Wasn't even on screen when I did that. It's hard to do this and watch it. Basically, it goes in. Turn it. There you go. So make sure it's good. And basically, we're going to do all those like that. I'm not going to show you every single one of them. Now, if you do like the high beam or the little lights, it does have the little one. You have one small one that you can do. I usually do just a high beam or something, because I don't ever mess with the other bulbs, because I don't want a bright-ass glowing, you need gas bulb or something. See enough of that anyways. So we'll probably just do the one blue one for the high beam, which is right here in the middle. Then you need to replace the big ones, because the big ones are what really illuminate everything. Your fuel, your speedometer and everything. So we're going to go ahead and replace them. So if you done did all this, I'm actually taking a step further, and we're gonna put a decal inside on the actual gauges. So what I'm taking apart now, you do not have to do if you don't want to put a decal or anything. You don't even have to. It's just I want to put one, because when I redo the gauge place, I'll have to take it off. But I just wanted to put one because it was too plain for me. And the blue LEDs was going to accent it really good. So you don't have to do this, but I hope you enjoy watching me do it. And then we'll put it back in the truck and try it out. We do have this. We just got to wipe it off, clean it up, and let's put it back in the truck. I'm going to have to do it like this. Yeah. That's how we do it. Alright, so you put it in from bottom up like that. That's how we do it. I've goofballed me. Alright, so you want to line these up. Then it just goes against that. It ain't that bright. I'll come back out here at night and do another one. But it is working. If
you can see it. I'll come back out here at night because you can always see it better at nighttime. I think it looks pretty good. We'll go ahead and put the rest of the dash back on. Don't forget you got 4 bolts to put on. Now, I did have to take it back out and turn some of the lights like I said you had to. If you did, you had to turn them. Take them out, move them around so they make good contact. So we did do that, so I'm actually going to go ahead and bolt everything back together. So we got our bolts back in. Let's go ahead and put this in park. We put our wheel up right now because we're gonna go ahead and put that down, and then we'll put the bezel back on. Take your key out. All right, so we pulled our wire through, and basically this little clip, we ain't put this in yet. Pulled the wire over here, turn this clip sideways, slides on, and it turns back so it won't come back off. We're going to slide our little clip in, and we'll be good to go. Real quick, there is a little track that wire goes in, so make sure it's in a track. So we just clip that in. You got to take 2 hands and do it, and it'll come out. That way it won't come out, and it won't go anywhere. That way when you put it in reverse, drive, park, whatever, it reads it right. So we're going to go ahead and bolt this piece back on. This is what I can't stand about when people put stuff back together and it's not right. Like that clip was bent over. Take time and do it right and not be in a hurry or something. All right. That is in. We get our 2 screws. Remember, you might have 3. I only have 2 because apparently somebody lost 2. Put this back up in here. Other screw in. We'll have to get it started first. All right, that is in. So let's go ahead and put the big bezel up here. All right, so remember, put your keys in, put it down. Now you can see it's actually showing park now. It wasn't even there. So the next thing when we switch is my ignition. The key don't like this one. Remember, put it down at first, and it's actually reading it, so we know we did that right. If your little orange thing isn't moving, then you need to go back down there because apparently something isn't installed correctly. But it's real simple. So put this back on. Be gentle with it because this one's already cracked. Cracked right there too. Goodness. Alright. So that's good. We get our lights on. Can't really see it right now, but we do have lights in there. I think that looks pretty daggone good. So that's how you put LEDs in there, basically. And it didn't take it the longest putting stickers on and stuff. So basically, I mean, if you have time, you could do this in easy 30 minutes, easy, if you just had all stuff. Because actually, Superam, I didn't take it in my shop. I actually just put all the stuff right here on. I didn't even put in the garage. I just held the speedometer thing right here in my lap because I was so nervous because I was like, God, I won't mess up. Like, Superam's my baby. It's like this one. Like, it's a YouTube channel build. So, this one's my, all my vehicles are my babies, but Superam is like my very first child, to say that. So, I take care of it. But this is how you do it. I mean, I think it looks pretty good. Hey, no, no, no. No, 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 anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you like and subscribe, because we're doing a lot more. Like I said, we're going to take this back out, put that cool thing I got to order. It's about $50 worth of stuff, and we're actually going to redo the back bumper on this truck, make it heavy duty, putting shackles and LED pod lights, and we're still doing crazy stuff to this truck all through the summer and stuff. It's actually just winter right now, but we're going to do it. We're starting now so we get ahead. But make sure you give us a like, punch that subscribe button. As always, this is George, and I'm out of here.